Hi, welcome to my new video. Today I show you some interesting stuff, starting with the White House. There are some conference rooms they show in this short clip, and here's one where many seats and a larger desk is located, and on the wall you see a projection of Mercator, this type of map. And a little bit later they show a room with only a smaller desk, and this may be a place where the president has sit, but behind his desk is a flat earth map with the North Pole in the center. I found this very interesting, and following is a view inside Chernobyl, which I found also interesting. Let's watch.
Dude, is this the holy? This is the world, man.
Yeah, this is the world. And I guess this is the North America.
Dude, look at. They drew some kind of line on the, like a border. So they had the whole thing planned. And this is way back in the day, so they had like a little. Someone made a world model here. For what reason, we don't know. Man, the Soviet Union had everything planned out. Well, at least they thought they did.
You see the stars and the dome-shaped structure and some kind of ice wall around the land they put there. And it seems very likely like a model of flat earth. A go-to page if you are interested in flat earth is plaintruth.info. They provide almost every day great information about the flat earth, research, new and older stuff. And lately they published a link to a research package which is very useful to look deeper into flat earth and the history of research and everything. So now I'll show you some interesting maps I came across. This is Middleton's pioneer map of the world, 1878, and this is of course a map with the North Pole in the center. And I want to point you to the descriptions on the outside. They are very telling and you should check them out for yourself. Basically it states that this is the only true model of the earth, and the globe is false, and the globe is the result of total disregard of the variation of the needle. And the needle is of course the magnetic needle of a compass, which always points to the North Pole, and this wouldn't work if the earth was a globe. You couldn't use a compass in Tasmania, for example. Yeah, this is basically what this map is all about, and you already see the ring of ice, which is also described here. So the next map I show you is the Gleason's new standard map of the world from 1892. It's basically a longitude and time calculator. You can see the path of the sun, the change in the seasons, and it's built like a clock, like a giant clock. It's every longitude line is 1 hour on this map. And the path of the sun, of course, takes 24 hours to go all around the earth. And yeah, this is how you read this map. Basically, the coordinates are all correct. I checked many of these, and this is a quite accurate map for this day also. So, and the next map I show you is the new correct map of the flat surface stationary earth. It's a map by John G. Abizet. It's a Syrian professor, And he had many friends, or some friends, who were conquerors or explorers of the world. And maybe with their help, he built this map. And it's very similar to the Gleason's world map. It's just showing the basics, the sun movement, the directions, South Circle, the ice, and some Syrian descriptions also. And the interesting thing on this map is the backside, because on the backside the author has given us some extra notes to describe this map. And this is also a very interesting read. You should check it out. It's also about the stupidity of the globe, and that the only true reality is described with a flat map with the North Pole in the center. And this guy, Abizet, had written some books, and the channel of Brian Clark has covered this map very often and in detail. You should check this his videos out. I'll provide a link also in the description. He found also a book of this Mr. Abizet, The Enlightenment of the World, from 1912. And the problem here is we all search for the third edition of this book, but it's not digitalized anywhere. But we find this one, and there are also interesting informations inside. The Enlightenment of the World. This book contains proof that the Earth is flat and stationary, while the Sun, Moon and stars are in constant motion. Also letters showing the testimony of scripture on the subject. So he's a little bit referring to the Bible here also. And yeah, you should check it out. There's also a lot of information. Yeah, testimonies. This is really interesting. Check it out. So, and when you search for maps, I found it also interesting to see how they changed over the years, and especially around the 15 and 1600s, they tried a lot of different kinds, but always trying to enforce the globe model with two poles, and this is just confusing to make such map projections. Yeah, it's not real. Maps are always used as a propaganda tool, I suggest, because there were no television, only little amount of papers and everything, and if you show such great maps with high quality, the people were really, really impressed, I guess. And they always try to show two poles and yeah, enforce the globe model with these kind of map. So this map I found very interesting because it's showing a lot of stuff. Of course, this is all propaganda. We will see very soon. And you see here a Mercator type map projection and the two poles. And around the map there are many informations also. Here we have the celestial objects in the sky, and we have the seasons on the right side, and on the left side we have the elements, and on the bottom of the map we have the seven ancient world wonders. And of course every world wonder of the ancient times was burnt down, except of the pyramids of Gizeh. Lighthouse from Pharos, and it was burnt down. And yeah, you see the other things like the mausoleum. Mausoleum is of course now known as a place where wealthy people bury themselves, and in mausoleums there are also many interesting architectures to find. And of course you find the triangle symbol and pyramids, but you find also dome shapes. And there was one mausoleum I came across in Germany. This is called Mausoleum Bückeburg. This is Europe's biggest mausoleum of this kind, and I found very interesting pictures showing the dome-shaped structure inside, and it's very similar to the regular flat earth maps. Now going back to the world wonders they showed here in the map, as I said, all were burnt down or destroyed except of the pyramids of Gizeh. And I found it very interesting how they were drawn here in this picture, because we don't see really pyramids, we only see some kind of obelisks. There are no pyramids in this picture, and I checked some other pictures too. Here's also an older picture of the seven world wonders, and you see here also the pyramids of Gizeh, and you see some kind of triangle pyramid type, but also only these obelisks. But how can this be? Yeah, how can this be the real history? All the history is fake.